Do you want to increase your visibility online using Google's organic free search? Do you want to get rich? Well, you're in the right place because today we're going to talk about Google Rich Results, which is a new feature that bloggers and website owners can do to help make sure they are parsing their content directly to Google so they can get more visibility within the search index. You have probably noticed Google's Rich Results as you have browsed the index lately, because what Google is doing is taking a lot of great content and putting it, like pulling it from the blog or website and putting it directly into the search result, right? So you get a lot of great information like show times, events, reviews, recipes, all kinds of great stuff right in the search index. And in this episode, we're going to talk about how this affects you, and you as a WordPress site owner can do a little bit of technical SEO to take advantage of this Google Rich Result program. The reason why you want to do this is because, do you want to be Coke or do you want to be Mr. Pip in the grocery store, right? By taking up more space on the proverbial shelf, if you will, you are going to bring more visibility for your website and more likely to get someone to click on your website. Now, it's a little dicey because with the rich results, it's actually answering a lot of people's questions before they actually even visit your website. And that's sort of a little controversial. Make sure that you do this type of rich schema markup for your website, because the more you do, the more likely Google is going to overall index your website on various search terms. So it's a good thing to do. The more you can do to help Google, the better off you're going to be in the long run. Plus, usually the websites and blogs that are like the number one rich result are the number one ranking on all websites for that particular query. So it's good to do it because at the end of the day, you're getting into the number one or number two spot on Google, which is what everyone covets for, right? And there's really no other alternative. What are you going to do? What's the alternative to this? Not doing it? Well, then you're kind of stuck. So let's talk about how you can leverage rich results with your WordPress site and some SEO techniques to make sure you get the stuff in place and ready to go. So here are some real-world examples of Google Rich Results in action. As you can see here, for a local arena that you can get all of the concerts and events like basically right in the search index, which is kind of nice. And if you click on one of these, it will take you to more of the event information. See here it's saying source the arena's website. Then, you know, obviously if you're looking for recipes or something like that, here are, you know, it kind of pulls information directly into the search index. So you can kind of see here's the 15 most popular recipes before you even go to the website. And another popular one, which is video content, especially videos that are on YouTube, they get pulled directly into the search index. So if you are looking, for example, how to vlog, here are obviously some suggested videos from Google that you might want to engage in, just because you get to see the thumbnail and the screenshots of them. In order for you to do this, you have to basically do a couple things. One, you need to first of all examine your overall website's content strategy, which of course we can help you with that. We're at contentacademy.com. But at the end of the day, you need to decide how and what type of content do I have that is ideal for a SERP, right, or for a rich result? And if so, then what type of additional sort of technical SEO do I need to do in order to make that happen? Because in order for some of these rich results to work, you need to provide Google with additional what's called structured data to get them into the search result. And the beauty with using WordPress is that it allows you to use more plugins, right? And there are a handful of really high quality plugins that let you do structured data markup within your content. So for example, if you have a website that maybe does product reviews, there are a handful of really great free and premium plugins that you can use to help create structured data around your product reviews. So for example, if you are searching for iPhone reviews, right, so it comes up in here and then you might find results, for example, iPhone XR review, and here you'll see like the star rating. So this is an example of a Google Rich markup. These used to actually be called Google Rich Snippets. They've changed the name from Rich Snippets now to Rich Results. Sorry, Google Rich Results. So this is what you can expect if you do have rich results. Obviously, too, like some other like low-hanging rich results that almost every website should look into doing is site links, which these are just basically additional links to other content on your website, and also, like, again, product review. So this one has a price, and just really kind of going for some of the low-hanging fruit. There's actually a ton of rich snippet options. There's a lot of great documentation surrounding all the different type of rich result sets. Some of them are like in beta, so they're not quite ready yet. Like, for example, Speakable and Top Places list is still in beta, but for example, events and courses and books, breadcrumbs, articles, events, these are all ones that are something you can use. And if you have book reviews on your website or if you have product reviews, boom, you should be doing this. This is a great way to get more visibility within the search index and drive more traffic to your content that you can go for. But most basic websites or most basic blogs and websites, if you're just getting into it, you probably are looking at site links, which the only way to really get site links is to submit a sitemap to Google Search Console. And Google Search Console is where you submit your website to Google and submit a sitemap so Google knows where and how to index and crawl your website. To do some of the more technical ones like breadcrumbs or articles or reviews, you probably will need an additional plugin that will help you do that. And of course, I will leave links to plugins in the episode information attached to this content. So be sure to check that out. Okay, so there is a litany of WordPress SEO plugins, and you know, you can ask 10 people and get 10 different recommendations. But since we're here, I thought I might as well go ahead and make some recommendations. Look, for sort of some of the basic rich markup or rich results type stuff like sitemaps and breadcrumbs, you probably want to use Yoast SEO. This is one of the most popular and respected SEO plugins within the WordPress community. So definitely want to check out. They have both a free and a premium version. Obviously, some of the more advanced or more technical SEO stuff is hidden in the premium version, but something to look at. Definitely a lot of good stuff is in the free version, so definitely worth checking out if you haven't already used this or you don't already use this. It's pretty popular. You may already even use this plugin, but something to consider. Another plugin that I've used, which I like, if you're looking to do more of the rich results specifically, like product reviews, recipes, book reviews, that kind of stuff, then the Schema plugin, all-in-one rich snippets plugin. They used to be called Rich Snippets. Now they're called Rich Results. Just recently, that was a recent announcement. So this is definitely another sort of freemium plugin that you can use to sort of structure your content in a way that Google can understand what it is and parse that additional information into the SERP or the search engine results page, right? So Schema is another one that I've used that I liked. And then finally, there's another more premium or freemium plugin. WP SSO Core is another one that I think is a great opportunity if you were looking to really dive into SEO plugins. This one is great, especially if you want to do a lot of local SEO. If you have multiple locations or you have a physical location for your business, I've had good success with this particular plugin. Again, it's a freemium model, so there's a free version, and then most of the good features are tucked away into a pro version. But definitely something to consider if you want to get more technical with your WordPress content and SEO. And then finally, in order for you to sort of do this on your website, is you're going to have to do a little bit of rinse and repeating. What I like to do is I like to create some content that I would expect to be in the Google Rich Result Index or be rich result friendly. For me, it's mostly events. I do a lot of websites with event calendars, and events are always great things to sort of take up more space in the search index. Naturally, it helps you create great high quality content because it's stuff that comes up and happens often, right? So for me, I create some events, and then what I do is I'll go to the Google Structured Data Testing Tool, or I believe now it's called the Google Rich Results Testing Tool, and you can use that to test to make sure if your content is working, right? If Google's getting the right type of schema markup that goes along with the content that you are creating. So you just have to kind of rinse and repeat. You'll maybe get some errors in Search Console, and those errors will help you decide if what you're doing is correct. And just keep trying and keep trying and keep trying. You probably may not have a lot of success if you don't have a lot of content. This is definitely more for somebody who has a lot of content and a lot of additional traffic to their site. If you kind of are just getting started, this is something to aspire towards, and it's always good to do it now because you never know, you might have the right type of content for the right audience. But if you don't, you know, don't worry about it, because at the end of the day, this is something that's really good, especially for mid to large websites where you get a lot of traffic and Google's doing everything they can to sort of take the best of your content and put it into the search result. It saves people time and saves people energy, and they're happy and then we're happy. Definitely check all this information out. I will leave more information regarding this into the episode notes. Thanks so much for listening. As always, be sure to check out our free Facebook group at wordmentor.com.